This is the W1209 temperature sensor. It has a thermocouple on it, and it has three switches. It has set, plus, and minus. And you can get these with a case. You have to take it apart yourself, take the stickers off. It takes a pretty good bit of time to do that, but it comes out with a nice case, like this right here. This particular style is blue. I have some that come in red. It didn't say how to be specific, like which color you get. And I guess you just get what they got available. When you hit the set button, well, it'll show you what the temperature it's set at. It'll keep flashing. When it gets done flashing, and that's what it's going to be set at. Okay, so it's at 30. So I'm going to go ahead and warm this up. I have a ground hooked up here to one pin and a positive 12 volts to the other. And then I use a jumper to go over to the relay, because there are two relay pins here. And then the last one I have hooked to the fan. There's a little LED that comes on. There's different settings that you can do, different parameters. P0 is heating and cooling mode. P1 is a hysteresis. P2 is set upper temperature. P3 is set lower temperature. P4 temperature offset. P5 trigger delay start in minutes. And P6 and P7 is high temperature alarm in degrees. Now, not all of them have all these codes. This particular one only goes up to P6. So, the hysteresis difference, whether it's on the cold side or hot side, is determined by P0. So if you have it on a cold setting, then it's going to do a compensation, hysteresis compensation on the cold side. For instance, it's 30. So then I got it set to 0.1, then it would be 29.9, it would kick on. But I have it set to hot, I believe. Just take the set button, push it down and hold it to access the P code. There it is. Now you can go plus or minus to go through the settings. As you can see, it recycles back to zero. The ones that have the P8, you can set it back to factory specs. There's P2, for instance. So if I hit set while it's on that, it shows 110. That right there is the upper limit. Hit set again, it goes back to P2. P3 is selected. Now it says minus 50. P3, that's the lower temperature limit. Okay, now it's cycled back to where it was from the beginning, because I took too much time to hit that button. It comes back within about 5 seconds. Not all of them have that red LED, but this particular one does. And the blue is pretty straightforward, easy to see. Anyway, that's about it. If you have any questions, just put them down below. There are multiple more settings. I'll hold it here for a second so you can see the settings. That's it.